I still haven't got the man cave all built and all the walls done. I know, you guys heard me talk about this like a week or two ago. Maybe it was a week or three ago, I don't know. But man, I haven't got around to it because I've literally been scouting, hunting, and editing so much. It's just taken all my time, and something like this, you know, getting all this wood up on the walls, getting the whole ceiling built, and then I have to insulate all the walls and the ceiling before I put all the wood up. This is going to be a little project that I'm going to bring you guys along on, and we're going to make a whole little studio back here, and it's going to be really nice. Big wall. You guys are going to help me decide what I want on that wall. I'm going to have a big Ducks emblem or a big Bobby Guy Films emblem with some big old geese landing or something. I'm just saying, I want it to look sweet. And I mean really sweet. Oh my goodness. Let me tell you about this video you're about to see. I just want to give you a little rundown about it because it needs a little explanation because it is a roost. Now I know I've said never hunt roosts. Don't ever bust a roost because you'll end up driving the birds out and you're not going to be able to hunt them on the fields. But the exception to that is waiting till the end of the season where it just doesn't matter anymore. They're going to be leaving. They are leaving. They're going back north anyways. And the end of the season, you don't have to worry about making anybody else mad by bumping their birds off that they're hunting in the fields, or waste your own hunting opportunities in the field by shoving those birds off that roost. End of the season, hammer them. That's what we did. I got invited like an hour away. It was unbelievable. These boys can call. Be ready for some beautiful team calling. Listen to the calling. You're going to enjoy it. You can learn a lot from it just by listening. These boys are bad. But at Ducks, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we're doing 25% off hats, t-shirts, then hoodies. Friday is hats, Saturday is shirts, Sunday is hoodies. So all 3 days, go over to the site, pick you up something, 25% off every single day. Well, let's get into the video. You guys are gonna love it because I loved it. Like, beyond. It was something new, and it's what you guys have wanted to see. Big old graders. These were graders, graders, not honkers. Graders over water. So, myself and Brad, show your lovely face, Brad.
What's up?
It is almost 2 o'clock. They got off about an hour and a half ago. They're usually only gone for about an hour and starts trickling back. We are 40 minutes away from the destination. My buddy Brayden, who you'll meet in a little bit, is going to call us if they start coming back while we're driving to get there. He's going to call and say, hey, turn around, go home. It's going to be a waste of time because they're all going to come back and you're not going to be here yet. And it's an hour drive, like I said. So, this is going to be cutting it extremely close. We are almost there. We have one more mile. It is 1:42. I have not got a call from Brayden saying that they're flying. I don't see anything in the air here. If there's wood, I'd be knocking on it, but I think we made it.
Here they come. I'm sitting over here. The blind is right there. Here they come. They're gonna do it dirty, dirty, dirty.
Yeah! Adrian!
Nice! Nice! Holy smokes! They got in there. Holy moly, they came in tight. Goodness!
That was that one.
Oh, that was beautiful. Oh my God. Oh, that was bad.
Did you get a good deal on
it? Oh yeah, I got it. I got it real good.
Dirty! Here, baby. Here. Back. Let's go. Fetch him up. Oh, shit.
That was dirty.
That was dirty. Woohoo! Holy moly.
Here. Good girl here.
She's like, this water is cold, Dad. Look at her fight through that ice. Get it. She a bad girl. Everybody's scrambling to get back in the blind. Literally just got the birds all picked up and we have another set on the way. They are coming back to roost hot and heavy. That was the first big set that they've had all day. And me and Brad got here 10 minutes ago. An hour drive, last minute. 10 minutes to spare. 10 minutes. So this is my sitting spot. I'm literally right at the water. Right here. Only like 5 foot. And I got this old pampas grass in between my legs. And then I got these behind me. I'm tucked up in here. In the shadow. Perfect. I got the best seat in the house right here.
Well, he set sail after some treasure. He dropped a dead goose, if you can see it right there. He's going after her. The problem is that ice is so thin you can't walk on it. And I believe he's gonna have a hard time breaking through the ice on a kayak.
Like 5 inches.
Beat it harder!
Uh-oh. He's getting a running start. Oh boy. Oh boy.
You're almost to it, like 15 foot. This might end up in a bad situation. Oh, look at that. He got up to it. Now he has to turn it around and get back to the water. Wow, what a trooper. Holy smokes. Now you gotta make it back to the water, man. He is getting it done. Good Lord, guy. He is just getting it done for the team. Wow. Freaking collegiate canoer, man. There she is. We're down here on the bank having a good time waiting for the birds to come back. We're gabbing, BSing, just having fun. But I want to show you guys a little bit of the terrain down here because it is beautiful. This little water hole down here is sweet. So this is all ice. This was all actually this morning. This was all ice all the way out to here. And the geese have been keeping this little hole open. We're sitting right there. The wind's coming this way, so the geese are going. There's our blind right there. I mean, they are literally decoying all the way at our feet, all the way up to the bottom of that A-frame over there. The part of the deal is hunting roosts. I know I preach, don't do it, but guys, it's the end of the season. The Canada goose season is getting ready to shut down. The ducks absolutely eat this place up. Pennies.
Oh, Mr. Old Red. Mr. Redhead wanted to come check us out. The ducks just love this little pond.
I don't even know what time it is. I'm sure it's 5 o'clock.
probably an hour left of shooting light, so we're gonna wait it out. With an hour left, boy, it's gonna be the witching hour. They're either gonna do it or they left and they're roosting somewhere else, so. These big boys come in pairs and threes coming back to roost, and they do it dirty, 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 dirty.
Kill them!
Both of them boys are dead. Goodness gracious, they're so fast. That is beautiful. Oh my goodness. Coming right over me. Oh, he is dead. Nice shot. It's getting late, you gotta shoot him.
Yeah. Hey, turn around and shot him from the back of the blind. Okay. They got him.
Straight up smoked him today. I didn't do much shooting. These boys did most of it. I did a lot of filming though. Caught a bunch of good content. Thanks for all the fellas for inviting me. Braden, Brad, everybody else, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. That was amazing. Oh, well, they all came back way after shooting light. Holy smokes. Mo, good boy. Here, sit. Sophie, you are just dangerous, let me tell you. Get the ball. Good boy. Old Jax, man, he's a retrieving son of a gun. He loves it. Look at him. You're a mess, dude. What'd you do? You can't go in the house like that. Mom's gonna kick your butt. All he cares about right now is that ball right there. He says, I don't care about what you're talking about. Just throw the dang ball. But I hope you guys enjoyed that big old honker video. Honkers over water. It was beautiful. Them boys knew what they were doing. They didn't touch that roost all year just so they could do that. The honkers started living there all year and they were like, you know what? Let's just see if they stay. And they did. And they made the best choice just by letting something stay. You've seen how natural those birds did it. The spread that Brad and Braden and Cameron and the boys set was perfect. It looked extremely natural. The calling sounded extremely natural. Low groaning, mild, minimum clucks when they're coming in close, and working your corners hard. When they're flaring on the corners or where they're turning on the corners, when they're circling, you hit them hard. Get them to keep turning and coming back. Go check them out on Instagram. Go follow them boys right here. They know what they're doing. Go give them a follow and check out what they got going on. But guys, don't forget the sale Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We're going to have 25% off each and every day.
But I want to thank you guys for watching. Like always, if you like this big old honker hunting over water roost video, give me a big old thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you on the next one. Peace. Yeah. Guala, 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 guala. I'm living like it's no tomorrow. Don't know my style, won't let you borrow. You're thirsty, have a glass of water. I'm killing these beasts, I'll be more dead.